teaching with digital tools and apps. Educating students is not just a matter of transferring knowledge, but is providing and creating meaningful learning experiences. Digital tools and apps can help to achieve these experiences if used correctly. We identified three areas we feel educators should be informed on when teaching using digital tools and apps: instructional design, features to consider when choosing and using such tools and apps, and digital literacy and safety. Designing instruction with Universal Design for Learning in mind helps to ensure that technology is being used to increase access to learning, give students choice over what and how they learn, and to create student-centered learning experiences. Designing instruction using backward design means there is more of a focus on learning, especially higher order thinking, rather than instruction practices. It is firstly identifying the student outcomes, then deciding how to achieve them. Using the TPAC model can help you narrow down your choices in deciding which digital tools and apps best meet your needs, and make sure that they fit in with the content and pedagogical approaches being used. When choosing technology to use in your classroom, you need to think about how beneficial it will actually be, so make sure to evaluate the tools and apps critically. You need to see whether it is connected to the real world, so your students can see the functionality of using it in the lesson, and you also need to look into its feedback capabilities, as for certain tools and apps, this could be essential so your students can see how to improve in their learning. You also want to make sure that the resource is engaging, developmentally appropriate, meets your teaching goals, provides motivation, and is accessible for all, many of which were mentioned earlier. Creating or using a checklist can be very useful when choosing digital tools and apps to use in the classroom. Lastly, when teaching using digital tools and apps, it is important to educate your students on how to be a good digital citizen, which is using technology in an ethical way that is consistent with learning. You and your pupils should also become familiar with the digital intelligence standards laid out by the DQ Institute. These standards include digital identity, digital use, digital safety, digital security, digital emotional intelligence, digital communication, digital literacy, and digital rights. We hope you feel more confident and excited to teach using digital tools and apps. If you haven't already, check out our book chapter by clicking on the link.